The poet Robert Browning famously wrote in 1855 that less is more. And in this video, we're going to talk about how writing less can actually increase the impact that you have as a writer. As a writer, it's easy to get carried away in some kind of explanation or to ramble on with incoherent examples and thoughts. We've all been there, we've all done it, and we know this intuitively, that quantity is not the same as quality. You know, have you ever read a book that just droned on and on and on about the most minute of details, page after page, sentence after sentence, chapter after chapter, goes on forever, and by the end, you just say, what? I could have gotten those same ideas in 10% of the time. You see, successful writers, they don't do that. They keep their stories compressed so that they can be engaging. And I always think back to Stephen Sondheim, the composer of West Side Story, who said, you have to throw out good stuff to get the best stuff. And what he's saying here is that the process of gathering ideas and then distilling them into a smaller and a more compressed form, that distillation is the essence of creative excellence. But the question is, where do you find these ideas and then the inspiration to dive into them? It's simple. Life is full of interesting experiences waiting to happen. And so what we want to do as writers is to get out into the world and explore. We want to focus on refinement and distillation later. We start by living. Because even full-time writers who are publishing all the time, they spend most of their time away from the keyboard. Because if they spent 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 hours every week typing, they'd have nothing new to say, no life experiences to actually pull from. And then by sitting down to make sense of their existing ideas instead of trying to invent new ones, writers at the computer, they mold the wet clay of experience into a beautiful and elegant shape. And the world has changed in a way that has made compression more important. You see, before the internet, we lived in an age of information scarcity, where some people had access to way more information than other people, and information was expensive for basically anybody to access. But today, everybody with an internet connection has access to more information than they know what to do with. We live in an age of information abundance. And so now, in this age of abundance, the art of communication is knowing how to compress all that information in engaging and informative ways. I always think about a 2008 Cornell University paper called Driven by Compression Progress. And this paper suggests that people make sense of the world by making it simpler and more beautiful, or by making compression progress. And the authors, they assert that creators move towards compression progress, not by following their rational mind, not by being logical, but by following their intuition for what's interesting. And in doing so, in that pursuit of interestingness, they compress large data sets into elegant and then bite-sized deliverables, which are both easy to share and remember. Because the more that information is compressed, the more efficiently it can travel from the creator of an idea to the consumer of it. And we know this intuitively. This is why Just Do It is such a famous slogan, because it compresses an entire philosophy of life and athletic excellence into just three words. And then there's Albert Einstein too, who compressed a large portion of how reality works with a simple formula, E equals MC squared. And few things are more satisfying to the human mind than concentrated gems of information that express a lot about the way the world works. And speaking of those gems, without the intense compression of carbon, diamonds would never be created. And diamonds are an excellent metaphor for writing and the importance of compression, because they're a form of ultra-concentrated carbon that's compressed in the Earth's molten core, 100 miles below your feet, at temperatures of 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit, where pressure exceeds 725,000 pounds per square inch. And the same thing works for the creative process, where most people, they view creativity as a generative process. But you know what? It's not just a process of addition. It's a process of subtraction, a process of removing things. And since our brains are driven by compression progress, what creatives are doing is they're looking for efficient ways to remember ideas so that they can spread, so that they can stick in our mind and be shared with friends. I always think back to ancient Greece, where the bards memorized those stories in the form of long-form poems that reflected the heart of a culture. And with each generation, those stories were compressed and enhanced, compressed and enhanced, compressed and enhanced, over and over again. And over time, those ideas were refined down to their essence, just like a diamond. And compressing can be useful in other ways as well. For instance, I always think of the art of map making, where every single map serves some kind of goal, some kind of utility. But believe it or not, maps weren't always easy to read. And this is because they weren't compressed. Or another way of looking at it, they were actually too accurate. So in 1933, Henry Beck saw that the London Underground was just too confusing, too hard to understand. And so he decided to simplify the subway map. And controversially, he abandoned geographic accuracy, which was the standard for these subway maps back then. And instead, Beck had another idea. He focused on the connections between trains and the networks of stations in London. And to focus on the most prominent parts of the subway system, he increased the relative scale of downtown areas because that's where most of the subways travel. All over the world, it's the same thing, from New York to Hong Kong.
Part of the process of map making is you're always deciding what not to include as much as you're deciding what to include, because you just want to have the map reader focus on a particular subject.
And thanks to the omission of extraneous details, these compressed maps portray only what riders need to see in order to reach their destinations. And you know what? That's just like good writing. I always think back to Einstein, who we talked about before, who said that things should be made as simple as possible, but no simpler. And as writers, if we can learn to refine our words down to the ideas that matter the very most, we can achieve our highest quality output and make every word count. And that is how you can be driven by compression progress. And for more ideas on improving your writing, check out my video on how to find great writing ideas.